ne communiquons pas par Facebook, nous n'offrons pas d'articles spirituels ou de réservations pour des visites à la synagogue Église de toutes les nations. Et nous ne fournissons aucun service par Facebook. Si quelqu'un vous contacte sur Facebook, prétendant être un représentant du prophète Tibi Joshua, de la synagogue Église de toutes les nations ou d'Emmanuel TV, sachez que vous avez affaire à un fraudeur. Prenez garde aux fraudeurs.
Advertencia. Cuidado con los estafadores. Hay numerosos usuarios que aseguran ser o representar al profeta Tibi Joshua, los hombres sabios o estar conectados con el ministerio de la sinagoga, Iglesia de todas las naciones y Emmanuel TV. Hay miles de impostores que están contactando personas por medio de Facebook y de direcciones falsas de correo electrónico pidiendo donaciones y ofrendas a cambio de artículos espirituales. También están pidiendo donaciones para proyectos benéficos falsos. Son estafadores y no tienen nada que ver con la SCOAN, Emmanuel TV o el profeta Tibi Joshua. Solo tenemos una página oficial de Facebook. www.facebook.com/tbjministries. Cualquier otra página o perfil que afirme estar asociado con el ministerio de Tibi Joshua o la sinagoga Iglesia de todas las naciones es falsa. Para cualquier duda, diríjase a nuestra página web www.emmanuel.tv y haga clic en el icono de Facebook. No nos comunicamos a través de Facebook, no facilitamos artículos espirituales, ni hacemos reservas para la sinagoga Iglesia de todas las naciones. Tampoco proporcionamos ningún otro servicio por medio de Facebook. Si alguien le contacta por medio de Facebook, afirmando estar relacionado con el profeta Tibi Joshua, la SCOAN o Emmanuel TV, está usted tratando con un estafador. Cuidado con los estafadores.
Attention. There are numerous fake websites, email addresses and social media accounts requesting or encouraging for donations in the name of the SCOAN, Tibi Joshua and Emmanuel TV. They may claim to be collecting funds to build a SCOAN worship center, Bible college or orphanage in their respective countries. Others also solicit funds for spiritual items to be sent out. They are fraudsters. There is currently no plan to build or acquire SCOAN premises worldwide. Don't let anyone deceive you. For donations, God has a way of speaking to the hearts of His people for our needs. We never send anyone and can never send anyone. If we need you, partners, we have a way of reaching you through Emmanuel TV, which is our mouthpiece. Following are just a few examples out of thousands of fraudulent announcements.
atención, hay numerosas páginas web falsas, direcciones de correo electrónico y cuentas de redes sociales pidiendo o alentando a dar donaciones en nombre de la SCOAN, TV Joshua y Emmanuel TV. Puede que afirmen estar colectando fondos para construir un centro de culto de la SCOAN, una escuela bíblica o un orfanato en sus respectivos países. Otros también solicitan fondos para artículos espirituales. Son estafadores. Actualmente, no está planeado construir o adquirir un local de la SCOAN en todo el mundo. No permitas que nadie te engañe. Para donaciones, Dios tiene una forma de hablar a los corazones de su pueblo para nuestras necesidades. Nunca enviamos a nadie y no podemos enviar nunca a nadie. Si les necesitamos, socios, tenemos un modo de informarles a través de Emmanuel TV, que es nuestro portavoz. A continuación, hay tan solo unos pocos ejemplos de entre los miles de anuncios fraudulentos.
Changing the world.
Even when you are, distance is not a barrier. Viewers, you are called to battle the spiritual entities which cause crisis in your lives. You and Prophet TV Joshua, together in the name of Jesus, can stop Satan killing, stealing, and destroying your life. Touch the screen right now. Engage with God.
Viewers all over the world, it is time for prayer. I will start this prayer by beginning to remove every barrier between your heart and the Spirit of God. The barrier could be offense, barrier could be unforgiven spirit. Whatever barrier between your heart and the Spirit of God, be removed in the name of Jesus. You have a role to play. What is your role? Your role is to begin to confess what you think is the barrier. You know yourself better than anyone. Begin to confess those barriers, those weaknesses. It could be unforgiven spirit, pain of the past, offense. You know, you don't need to hold offense, whether you are right or wrong. So right now, open your lips and begin to confess it right now. Barrier between your heart and the Spirit of God. You need to humble yourself, confess your weakness, say to the Lord, I'm sorry. Open your lips, begin to confess them. Lord Jesus, help them to pour their heart. Ask God to help you to pour your heart. Say, I want to pour my heart. Strengthen me, Lord. Viewers all over the world, I say to that barrier between your heart and the Spirit of Father, be removed in the name of Jesus. You barrier be removed. You barrier be removed. Between your heart and the Spirit of God. Let there be communication. Let there be contact. Let there be communication. Let there be contact. Let there be communication. Let there be contact. In the name of Jesus.
We leave you under the influence of the Holy Spirit and pray to meet you there again. Allow your heart to be deeply engaged with God as you send your testimony. Engage with God.
Emmanuel, Emmanuel, my name is Suresh Kurian Patani. I am coming from India. This is my wife, Seema Suresh. This is Anson Thomas, and he is Mr. Bharat Kumar. We all are from India and represent a team in India. I am here to testify a wonderful miracle we have received during watching Emmanuel TV. In 2013, when my wife was watching a testimony of a South African lady, when she saw that the lady got miraculously healed, and that inspired her to pray to the God with all her heart to see the same miracle in her life. We had an accident 6 years back. Her shoulder fractured and she had an implant. She was not able to raise her arm above a certain level. After watching the Emmanuel TV, praying along with Prophet TB Joshua, she was able to lift her hand miraculously all the way up.
Shall we put our hands together for Jesus? Put your hands together for Jesus. You said she had this problem of fracture and she could not raise her hand.
Not only raise the hand, she had difficulty in doing the household work. She was unable to take care of small children. And I always used to assist her in the homework.
And when she watched Emmanuel TV, tell us what happened.
She was praying to the Lord that she would also like to receive the same healing which the person who was testifying in the Emmanuel TV received. The same day, the same moment, she was kneeling down and praying, and she was able to lift her hand immediately.
Shall we put our hands together for Jesus?
Not only that, after we received this miracle of my wife, we as a team, we got inspired. We started installing Emmanuel TV across South India, different states in South India, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, and Kerala. We have accomplished around 100 installations of Emmanuel TV, which is connected to a Thaicom C5 satellite, which is a 6-foot dish. And we are not a technician of Emmanuel TV, but we learned by grace of God the installations, and now we are able to move around and install it. We are professionals, we are working in offices. Even in my career, the testimony goes, I was having a stagnated career in my office. I was promoted to my next level as a department leader in my office.
Shall we put our hands together for Jesus?
Not only my wife's deliverance, my friend who came in 2012, who also received the miracle deliverance, and we knew the power of God working in synagogue, and we want to take this message across the country of India and make sure that the people really see and feel and encourage with the power of God and understand the true God in the nation of India. That was our motive and drive to install Emmanuel TV in different homes in India. We installed Emmanuel TV in orphanages. We installed it in pastors' home and also other persons who are interested in watching the Emmanuel TV.
Emmanuel viewers, and glory be to God. My name is Seema Suresh and I come from India. The person standing next to beside to me is my husband, Mr. Suresh, and Anson and Bharat. We are all come from a team as from India actually. So like we would like to give our testimony and glorify God, because he has done something wonderful in our lives. And before I begin my testimony, I would also like to add that this is so wonderful to me because I come from a family which never believed in God. So I was born and brought up in that way, and like when even the TV was installed in my house, I was never interested so much in watching that, and I could never believe all that was happening here because coming from a family which didn't believe in God, I never used to believe in the works of Satan also. So you can understand, like I came in touch with God through this channel. This is where God was introduced to me. Before watching Emmanuel TV, our car met with an accident. The vehicle we were traveling met with an accident. It was, I think, 6 years back. So in that accident, I got a severely fractured, and the ball and socket joint is there here in the shoulders. The ball got completely fractured. There was a lot of damages in the ball, and I had a major surgery. After that, like even after 2 years, I couldn't receive the healing properly. It was not getting healed properly.
Meaning, even after the surgery, there was no solution?
Yeah.
Is that correct? There was no solution?
Yeah, there was no solution in the sense the fracture got healed, but there was a lot of pain. I couldn't lift my hand up. Even the fracture was getting healed very slowly.
Can you explain to us what were the things you could not do when you had this problem?
When I had this problem, I could not lift. Actually, my hand to the front, it used to come only till here and to the side till here. Maybe a little more to the front and side till here. So whatever I had to do with my hand lifting up, nothing could be done.
What about household activities?
Household activity, everything had to be at this level, whatever I can do. And nothing left, even if I had to put clothes. And my son was just 2 years old at that time when I met with that accident. So it was very difficult even to take care of him. I had to always carry him with one hand, putting him in my legs and like just throwing a pump to carry him. It was very, very difficult. And even the household chores was a great pain because like once the right hand, it's very difficult to do the household chores. So it was great pain and agony for me. And like I was very depressed. And actually before this accident, Emmanuel TV was installed in our house. I just started watching it and like my faith was building up a little. And it was that time this accident happened. But the strange thing is that I never lost hope in God after that. Like, I don't know, the channel gave me so much hope. And for a person who has never believed in God, it was a major tragedy. When you start believing that God is there, you get hit by such an accident. It's really depressing. But somehow that installation of Emmanuel TV in the house, I think, worked so much that I didn't lose hope.
Can you tell us again, who were the people that were assisting you to do some of the things you could not do before, like taking care of the kids and other household activities?
Household activity, my husband used to help. Other things, whatever I could do with my left hand, mainly I would do. And like with this level, whatever I could do, I used to perform that.
And when you watched Emmanuel TV, tell us your personal experience. What happened to you?
So after the accident, I was just watching the testimony of a South African lady, and they were just going to her house and like retelecasting her healing, what happened to her when she came to school, and she was just describing how she went to school and got her healing. So I was just watching her, and I think she had severe back pain, she had a belt or something on her, and she was also in a condition where she couldn't do the household work, it was very difficult to move. So just something just kept me back, like to watch that testimony. I had work, but something just pulled me down to sit on that sofa and watch the testimony. So as I started watching it, like they were showing how she came to school and she was like set for the prayer line. The prophet came to pray for her. But something I noticed about her was her faith. But she was like, just let the prophet touch and I'll be healed. I could see it in her that the moment he came near, she was ready to jump out of the chair. It was that kind of faith she had. So it inspired me very much. I thought, Lord, what kind of, this woman has great faith. Please give me that kind of faith. Even I want my healing. If she can be healed, even I can be healed. You can use your prophet to heal me also. Please heal me. I was just praying there. Then when the prophet touched her, she just as she was like ready, she just jumped out of the chair. She was running here and there with joy. I don't know, I felt very happy for her also. And like, I think a worship song was going behind. I just knelt down to pray. And as I was worshiping, tears were flowing down my eyes. Even I was like, God, even I want to receive my healing. Give me the faith to receive my healing. And without knowing, I just lifted my hand up. And first time when I lifted it up, I didn't realize, because I was so involved in the worship and prayer, I didn't realize that my hand had lifted up fully. Then,
shall we clap for wonderful Jesus? When she used her faith to put a demand on the anointing that was flowing through Emmanuel TV, she received a radical transformation. Tell us more about this.
And then I suddenly realized that my hand has actually gone up. I couldn't believe myself. I just checked it twice more, like by lifting it up, and it was a miracle for me. Like the God, the healer, had touched me through his anointed prophet, through the TV screen. A person who never believed in God or any prophets or pastors, through a TV screen, I received my healing, a touch of God from his anointed prophet, and it was something of a miracle in my life. I was introduced to God, the healer, to know that Prophet TV Joshua is a true man of God.
And shall we clap for wonderful Jesus? Tell us, ever since then, what are the things you have started doing?
I can do everything. I play badminton, I can do all the household works. In fact, I feel my hand is working more than before, like when I had a fracture.
What about taking care of the children?
Yes, everything. I can do everything what a normal person can do, and I feel more better.
What about raising your hands?
Yes, to the glory of God, I can raise it.
Shall we clap for wonderful Jesus? You just raise your hand now. Can you raise it again? Do you feel any pain?
No, nothing.
Before now, you could not try to raise it?
No, only this much.
But now you can raise it.
Yeah, I have.
Can you raise it once again? Any pain?
Not at all.
People of God, let's clap for Jesus. Viewers all over the world, distance is not a barrier. We thank God for what God has done for you, and we just want to hear from you. What advice do you have for viewers all over the world?
The advice I have to viewers all over the world is just believe. God doesn't look at your money in the pocket, or whether what you can do outside or externals is not what God is looking at. Because I'm telling this because there might be so many people after watching Emmanuel TV who might want to come here, but they might not be able to do so. So God can touch you anywhere through his prophet, through this medium of Emmanuel TV. I was healed before coming here, and I had just started believing in God. If God can touch me through this medium, he can really touch you. He looks at the person's heart, not as its pockets or any of his externals. He just sees that faith, that desire that will lead you to him. You can receive your healing touch, your deliverance, your blessing. God can use any medium. So please keep watching Emmanuel TV.
My name is Anson Thomas, and I'm from India. The people who are standing beside me are the team. We have come together from India. They are my friends. So it all started in the year 2012 when myself and two other brothers came to Synagogue Church of All Nations seeking for God's intervention in our lives, for our deliverance. Previously, one of our brothers had problem in his stomach, and myself, I had evil attacks in the dream, and this was preventing us from walking with the Lord, and this has made us make us in no progress in our life. So we came here by God's grace. So in the year 2012 we came here, and by God's grace the light of God located us and delivered us completely. So when we went back home in India, so we wanted something to help us to keep what we received. So we were searching for Emmanuel TV, because previously we used to watch through internet, through broadband. So it was costing us a lot of money for us, as well as it was difficult for us to watch continuously 24/7. So we decided to seek for any technician or any professionals who can come and fit the dish for us. We searched and we found one technician who can fix the dish. He came over and after many hours, he was able to catch the signal and helped us get the Emmanuel TV dish. After that, we used to watch Emmanuel TV, and you saw the testimony of our sister here, how she got healed by just watching a testimony of a lady on TV, and immediately her hands raised up. So this inspired us to spread this, to let other people know, other Christians, other believers who are not aware of such kind of deliverance, where they can be set from darkness to light. So we decided to fix Emmanuel TV dish in other people's home. So this inspired us, and we went to different places to fix the dish. But what happened was, each time we tried to install the dish antenna, the signal wouldn't come, or there would be problems, and we were finding it difficult, because it was very difficult to get the technician also to different places. And so by the grace of God, God opened our eyes of understanding, because we are all computer engineers. We have no idea of fixing the dish. God miraculously opened their eyes, and we were able to learn how to tune the Emmanuel TV, and we were able to capture the signal.
Shall we put our hands together for Jesus? And ever since you've been going from one home to the other to install Emmanuel TV for people, what changes have you seen in the lives of these people?
Yeah, ever since that, we were able to fix the Emmanuel TV dish in around 100 homes around the South India. Even we have fixed dishes in the orphanages, in pastors' homes. And due to this, what happened was, we get testimonies like, there was a mother who was watching Emmanuel TV in her home, and at that time she saw two strange men walking upstairs to the terrace to dismantle, to pull out the cables of Emmanuel TV. Later that week, the son of that mother came to our church, where he manifested and the demon started to speak that we sent two demons physically to go to the terrace to dismantle the Emmanuel TV cables. But they could not do because there were angels guarding the dish antenna.
Shall we put our hands together for Jesus?
And there were instances where the demons used to send thunder and rain to destroy the signals and dish. But each time they tried to do that, they could not do because there was always a fire around that house where the Emmanuel TV dish antenna is placed. And there are other instances where people have called us and said that they saw a prophet coming to their dreams and intervening and praying for them.
You mean Prophet T.B. Joshua?
Yes, Prophet T.B. Joshua comes to their dream and prays for them, and because of that, their problems are chained and they are set free.
Shall we clap for wonderful Jesus?
And there is one more instance where a girl, where there was a home that we went and fixed the dish antenna, and there was a girl in that house. She always had a problem in the stomach. Always there was an object that keeps popping up in her stomach. So after we fixed the Emmanuel TV there, when she came to the church, when during the time of deliverance, the demon started to manifest and say that they are very angry at us because, why did you fix that Emmanuel TV there? Because of that Emmanuel TV, we are not able to operate in their house. And Because of that, that family is now delivered, and we see a lot of testimonies coming out of this.
So we clap for wonderful Jesus. What words of advice do you have for people?
As the Bible says in Psalms 125, verse 1, those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion, which can never be shaken, never be moved. Emmanuel TV is a tool that God has given us as a blessing, so that when we keep watching that, our trust in God increases and we will never be shaken and never will be moved.
Right now we just want to hear a final word of advice from our dear brother. Tell us, sir, what words of advice do you have for viewers all over the world?
The viewers all over the world, my advice is that the Prophet T.V. Joshua is a real man of God, and his anointing and the blessing which he received from God, the truth of Jesus, the revelation of the love of Jesus, you can watch through Emmanuel TV and keep your faith growing. Let us have the hope in Jesus. I request all of you to continue to watch Emmanuel TV 24/7. Never switch it off.
So we clap for wonderful Jesus. And we are glad to let you know that the miracle that takes place in this place is for the salvation of your soul. So in order to stay true to Jesus, you have to make God's word the standard for your life and continue to spread the good news of our Lord Jesus Christ through what you're doing already, by doing more in terms of extending your hand of love, installing Emmanuel TV for people who are yet to discover it. And as you do this, God will bless you more abundantly in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Continuamos con más testimonios, como vemos en pantalla. Estas personas vienen desde el país de India. Ellos nos comentan que tuvo la oportunidad en el año 2012 de llegar hasta la sinagoga iglesia de todas las naciones y ver todo el servicio, tener la mañana y todo el mensaje del profeta T.V. Joshua. Y esto no quedó así, sino que regresaron a su país. Nos comenta uno de ellos que su esposa tenía un problema severo en el hombro, en el cual le impedía mover completamente, gozar de las facultades completas de su brazo, y en el cual ella de hecho nos comenta que venía de una familia no cristiana, ella no creía en nada, ella tuvo la oportunidad de presenciar los testimonios en Emmanuel TV, y pues estaba tan entretenida, tan en fe en el canal, que de pronto vio como ella simplemente empezó a mover el brazo y alabar a nuestro Señor Jesucristo. De hecho, nos comenta, es como ella conoció a Dios y a nuestro Señor Jesucristo en este milagro que recibió al ver la televisora Emmanuel TV. No obstante esto, estas personas, al ver este gran testimonio y muchos testimonios aquí en la Sinagoga Iglesia de todas las naciones, decidieron instalar el satélite de Emmanuel TV en su país, lo cual con muchas vicisitudes y problemas, puesto que no es común encontrar técnicos o este tipo de satélite o de dish en el país, e instalarlo en diferentes casas. Sin embargo, por fe, lo fueron instalando en diferentes casas, y los testimonios entre muchos de estos fue que una persona la había instalado en su techo y vio de pronto esta mujer dos hombres extraños que trataron de arrancar los cables y desecharlo. El hijo empezó a manifestarse. Al momento de ser liberado, él confesó que efectivamente había mandado dos agentes satánicos, dos demonios, para desconectar la televisora Emmanuel TV. Igual recibió su liberación y su sanidad, así como otros testimonios de ver cómo las sanidades empezaron en muchas de estas personas y de estas familias. También empezaron a comentar de cómo soñaban con el profeta T.V. Joshua, trayendo sanidad y libertad en cada una de ellas. Gloria a Dios, esta familia nos comenta este gran progreso de instalar el satélite de Emmanuel TV en su país, en la India, y de tener y comentar muchos testimonios que han ocurrido y que seguirán ocurriendo en su país de la India. Gloria a Dios, continuamos aquí en la Sinagoga Iglesia de todas las naciones.
Venez d'écouter cet encourageant témoignage de Monsieur Sima Suresh, venu d'Inde avec sa famille et son ami. En 2011, son épouse, qui regardait Emmanuel TV, a vu un témoignage de quelqu'un qui a reçu sa guérison. Elle-même souffrant d'une fracture à l'épaule depuis un accident 6 ans auparavant, elle ne pouvait pas s'occuper de sa famille ou même redresser son bras, malgré plusieurs opérations qui ont été faites pour améliorer sa condition. Alors que l'homme de Dieu, le prophète Tibi Joshua, priait, son épouse s'est mise à prier avec lui et en levant les mains, elle s'est vue, et pour la gloire de Dieu, elle s'est vue qu'elle pouvait lever les mains, elle a été guérie pour la gloire de Dieu. Et depuis ce miracle, ensemble, ils ont été encouragés pour installer des décodeurs, installer Emmanuel TV à travers le pays pour plusieurs personnes. Et beaucoup depuis ont reçu leur délivrance et leur guérison. Un témoignage intéressant qu'ils ont narraté était celui où un démon qui confessait pendant une délivrance qu'il essayait de détruire les antennes et les tours et en envoyant d'autres démons pour couper les câbles ou utiliser la météo pour brouiller le signal. Mais ils étaient tenus en échec car il y avait des anges qui gardaient les câbles et des colonnes de feu pour garder les tours. Ensemble, ils conseillent à tous de continuer à regarder Emmanuel TV, instrument que Dieu utilise pour en sauver beaucoup. Ils rendent grâce à Dieu ensemble pour la miséricorde de Dieu dans leur vie.
Somebody needs your testimony to strengthen their faith, to get them out of their desperate setback. When you acknowledge God as your healer, as your redeemer, and as your savior, he will do it again and again. So what is your testimony? Share it with us. Log on to www.emmanuel.tv, then click on Testimonies. Then type in your name, email address, and other details in the spaces provided. If you wish to upload a picture to attach to your testimony, click on the Browse button, select the picture from where you saved it on your computer, and click Open. Next, type in your glorious testimony in the box below, then click Submit. You can also share your testimony by calling our testimony lines. Each time God leads us through a battle, it is in our own interest to testify to His goodness as a way of thanksgiving for not allowing our adversaries to triumph over us. We look forward to hearing your testimony. The best is yet to come.
Jesus said to him, I'm the way, not I'm a way, but I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. That is, He is the beginning, the middle, and the end. As the truth, He is the source. As the life, He is the end of this. It has no beginning, it has no end. You have beginning, you have end. That life is internal life. That is the nature of God. Jesus and the way are one. By looking into the word and acting on it, you bring Jesus to the scene. When you pray, you must bring Jesus to the scene. Here is master statement. No one can approach God but through me. The sinner cannot reach God except through Him. The unshaved might cry to God for 1,000 years, but if there is no mediator, there will be no hope for them. because no man can approach God without the mediator. Jesus came to restore the relationship and fellowship between God and man. Jesus is the sinner's only savior, the way, the reality. There is no reality outside him. When a Christian sin, fellowship is broken. But he does not lose his place as a son. We have someone at the right hand of God intercede. Whoever remains faithful, man not only needs a mediator, but after he becomes a Christian, he is living in a world dominated by Satan. As a Christian, looking at your immediate surrounding, what you see is frightening. Economic oppression, poverty, physical oppression, disease and disability, demonic oppression, occultic practice, and ritual murder. Are you talking of religious oppression? Intolerance and violence everywhere. Are you talking of moral oppression? Institutionalized corruption in high places. His ministry of intercession is little appreciated by believers. In every temptation, in every trial, in every hard place Jesus ever lived to pray for us. A Christian can make a bad mistake. The difference is that they already have a relationship. They go to God immediately about their behavior, and the Lord helps and gets them back on their feet and forgives them and help them not to make the same mistake. When you make a mistake, don't run for God, run for him. When you have a relationship with Jesus, you change and become a man who is directed by the Holy Ghost. A privilege to let him instruct you. God wants to be involved in everything concerning you. Walk you through whatever life brings. Let someone say, our mediator. I declare that this is your time for miracle.
You loved God's wisdom. You felt God's touch. You treasured God's presence. You wanted more. Now, DSTV Channel 390 brings you Emmanuel TV. Distance is not a barrier to the move of God. Watch TV Joshua on Emmanuel TV 24 hours a day, 7 days a week on DSTV Channel 390.
To witness more about the ministry of TV Joshua and the Synagogue Church of All Nations, tune in to Emmanuel TV. And wherever you are, get connected. If you are in Africa or parts of Europe, you can find us free to air on the Intelsat 20 KU band Europe Africa beam. If you have any free to air decoder, please refer to our website www.emmanuel.tv for full details on how to tune in. If you are watching from Asia, Australia, Middle East, or parts of Europe, you can find us free to air on the Ticom 5 C-band global beam. If you are watching from North America, including USA, Canada, and Mexico, you can also find us free to air on the Galaxy 19 satellite. Alternatively, you can watch us 24 hours a day, 7 days a week from anywhere in the world on the internet. Just log into our website www.emmanuel.tv or download our official Emmanuel TV mobile app to view us on your mobile device. For more information about the channel, you can send us an email to info@emmanuel.tv. Emmanuel TV, changing lives, changing nations, and changing the world.
Pour voir plus, entendre plus, être témoin de plus du ministère du prophète Tibi Joshua et de la synagogue église de toutes les nations, connectez-vous sur Emmanuel.tv. Et là, vous vous trouvez, soyez connectés. Si vous êtes en Afrique ou en Europe, trouvez-nous gratuitement sur Intelsat 20 KU Band. Dans le rayon d'Afrique et d'Europe, si vous avez un décodeur libre, référez-vous à notre site internet www.emmanuel.tv pour plus de détails sur comment vous connecter. Si vous regardez de l'Asie, l'Australie, Moyen-Orient, Europe, vous pouvez aussi nous trouver gratuitement sur Ticom 5 C-Band sur un rayon global. Si vous nous regardez de l'Amérique du Nord, les États-Unis, le Canada et le Mexique, vous pouvez nous trouver gratuitement sur Galaxy 19 Satellite. Alternativement, vous pouvez nous regarder 24 heures sur 24, 7 jours sur 7, partout dans le monde sur Internet. Connectez-vous sur notre site internet www.emmanuel.tv ou téléchargez notre application mobile officielle sur votre smartphone. Pour plus d'informations concernant la chaîne, vous pouvez nous envoyer un email à info@emmanuel.tv. Emmanuel TV, changez les vies, changez les nations. Change the world.
Para ver más, escuchar más, para ser testigo de más del ministerio de TV Joshua y la sinagoga, iglesia de todas las naciones, conéctate a Emmanuel TV desde donde quiera que estés. Si estás en África o en alguna parte de Europa, nos puedes sintonizar al aire en el Intelsat 20KU en la frecuencia de señal de Europa África. Si tienes un decodificador para señal abierta, infórmate en nuestra página web www.emmanuel.tv sobre cómo sintonizarnos. Si nos estás viendo desde Asia, Australia, Oriente Medio o alguna parte de Europa, nos puedes sintonizar al aire en Ticom 5C en la frecuencia de señal global. Si nos estás viendo desde América del Norte, incluyendo Estados Unidos, Canadá y México, nos puedes sintonizar al aire en el satélite Galaxy 19. Alternativamente, nos puedes ver las 24 horas, los 7 días de la semana, desde cualquier parte del mundo a través del Internet. Simplemente conéctate a nuestra página web www.emmanuel.tv o descarga nuestra aplicación oficial de Emmanuel TV para podernos ver desde tu teléfono móvil. Para recibir más información acerca del canal, nos puedes mandar un correo a info@emmanuel.tv. Emmanuel TV, cambiando vidas, cambiando naciones y cambiando el mundo.
Good morning, viewers around the world. I'm here today with a special message from Prophet TB Joshua about the secrets behind his consistent good health over the years, despite the demands of ministry. You see, blessing without good health is a crisis because you cannot enjoy it. As 1 Thessalonians 5 verses 22 to 23 says, we are a spirit, we have a soul, and we live in a body. This same body can get sick, can get tired, and needs attention. In other words, the natural and the spiritual must function together. For the natural to function, you must take care of your body. So the question is, well, how should we? How should we care for our body? Well, brethren, listen to this revelation from God to Prophet TB Joshua. Water therapy. Prophet TB Joshua explained that before his morning prayer, or immediately after it, we're talking of 4 a.m., 5 a.m., 6 a.m. in the morning, he will take a 150 centiliters bottle of water. That's 1.5 liters. He'll pour it into a glass and in under 2 to 3 minutes, make sure he finishes the entire bottle. Now, the Prophet explained, I'm not drinking it because I'm thirsty. I'm drinking it for a purpose, to flush my system. Now, After taking this large bottle, you should then take another smaller bottle, 75 centiliters or 0.75 liters, between 2 to 3 p.m. in the afternoon, and then another one again around 5 to 6 p.m. in the evening. And one thing you have to understand, this water therapy should replace all sugary drinks if you want to enjoy a good and a healthy life. The question you may be asking is, well, which water should I use? Well, you can purchase, you know, bottled water, or you can just use normal, ordinary water from the tap. But one thing is clear, the water should be room temperature, normal water, not icy or cold water. After taking this water early in the morning, please note that you may urinate several times over the course of that morning, and you'll see that your urine is pure and clear. So by the time you notice your urine becoming a little bit yellowish early in the afternoon, it's a sign that you need to go and take another bottle of water. And brethren, the benefits of this habit, this water therapy, are so many, although it will be difficult to cultivate at the beginning. Firstly, it will moderate your eating habits. It will help fight sickness and disease in your system. It will also help you in losing weight. It will foster the growth of your hair, your nails. It will purify your skin. Truly, God has given us everything we need to live a good and healthy life. So brethren, this water therapy is the key to capture your health. And as you follow this instruction in righteousness from our Father in the Lord, Prophet T.B. Joshua, we look forward to hearing your wonderful testimonies in Jesus' name. Once again, good morning. Thank you, Jesus.
Buenos días, televidentes de todo el mundo. Hoy estoy aquí con un mensaje especial del profeta T.B. Joshua sobre el secreto detrás de su constante buena salud a través de todos los años, a pesar de los requerimientos de su ministerio. La bendición sin buena salud es una crisis porque no la puedes disfrutar. Como dice en 1 Tesalonicenses 5, 22 al 23, nosotros somos un espíritu, tenemos un alma y vivimos en el cuerpo. El mismo cuerpo puede enfermarse, cansarse y requiere atención. Lo natural y lo espiritual deben trabajar en conjunto para que lo natural funcione. Debes cuidar de tu cuerpo. Entonces, ¿cómo deberíamos cuidar nuestro cuerpo? Bueno, así que escuchemos esta revelación de Dios para el profeta T.B. Joshua, la terapia del agua. Explicó que antes o inmediatamente después de su oración en la mañana, refiriéndose a las 4, 5 o 6 de la mañana, toma una botella de agua de 1.5 litros y la sirve dentro de un vaso y dentro de 2 o 3 minutos se asegura de terminarla. Según él, el secreto detrás de esto no es beber agua cuando tiene sed, como es de costumbre. Él dijo, no la tomo porque tenga sed, yo la tomo por un propósito, para limpiar mi sistema. Después de esta botella grande, deberías tomar una botella pequeña de 750 mililitros entre las 2 o 3 de la tarde y una más alrededor de las 5 o 6 de la tarde. Esta terapia del agua debería reemplazar todas las bebidas azucaradas si quieres tener una buena vida. La pregunta que tal vez te haces, ¿qué tipo de aguas deberías tomar? Puedes comprar agua embotellada o simplemente puedes tomar agua normal del grifo. Pero una cosa es clara, el agua debe estar a temperatura ambiente, no fría ni helada. Después de tomar el agua muy temprano en la mañana, fíjate que puedes orinar varias veces y te darás cuenta que tu orina es pura y clara. Cuando notes que tu orina se torna más amarilla, es una señal que deberías tomar otra botella de agua. Los beneficios de este hábito son múltiples, a pesar de la dificultad de cultivarlo al principio. Primeramente, regulará los hábitos alimenticios, combatirá la enfermedad en tu sistema, ayudará a perder peso, promoverá el crecimiento del cabello y uñas y también purificará la piel. Verdaderamente, Dios nos ha dado todo lo que necesitamos para vivir una buena vida. Hermanos, Esta terapia del agua es la clave para capturar tu salud para la gloria de Dios. Mientras siguen esta instrucción en justicia, esperamos escuchar los maravillosos testimonios en el nombre de Jesús. Buenos días.
Bonjour téléspectateurs du monde entier. Je suis ici avec un message spécial du prophète Tibi Joshua. Message donné le dimanche 4 janvier 2015, révélant à la congrégation de la synagogue Église de toutes les nations le secret derrière sa bonne santé. Il n'a jamais été absent d'une réunion de dimanche, ni voyagé à l'étranger pour un traitement médical à cause de ce secret. Une bénédiction sans une bonne santé est une crise parce que vous ne pourrez pas en savourer le plaisir. 1 Thessaloniciens 5, versets 22 à 23 dit que nous sommes un esprit, nous avons une âme et nous vivons dans un corps. Le même corps peut être fatigué et avoir besoin d'attention. Parce que le naturel et le spirituel doivent fonctionner ensemble, pour bien vivre dans le naturel, vous devez prendre soin de votre corps. Comment donc prendre soin de son corps? Écoutez donc cette révélation du prophète Tibi Joshua concernant sa vie, la thérapie de l'eau. Il dit qu'avant ma prière du matin ou immédiatement après ma prière du matin, je parle de 4h, 5h ou 6h du matin, je bois cette bouteille d'eau qui est une bouteille de 150 centilitres, c'est-à-dire 1,5 litre. Je verse successivement le contenu dans un verre et en moins de 2 à 3 minutes, je m'assure de boire tout le contenu de la bouteille d'eau. Je répète, je finis la bouteille entière en moins de 2 ou 3 minutes. C'est un peu difficile au début, mais avec le temps, on s'y habitue. Les gens boivent parce qu'ils ont soif. Je ne bois pas, dit-il, parce que j'ai soif. Je bois pour un but, pour purger mon système. Après cette grande bouteille, vous devez prendre maintenant une bouteille de 75 centilitres entre 14h et 15h et boire encore une nouvelle bouteille de 75 centilitres autour de 17h et 18h. Cette eau remplace toutes les boissons sucrées. Elle ne doit pas être glacée ni froide, que l'eau soit à la température ambiante, c'est-à-dire de l'eau ordinaire. Ce que je vous demande de faire, dit le prophète, est ordinaire. Abandonnez les glaçons, dites au revoir à la glace. Pour ceux qui n'ont pas les moyens d'acheter des bouteilles d'eau quotidiennement, prenez juste de l'eau du robinet et remplissez la bouteille, tout simplement. Mais dit-il, il y a une différence entre avoir soif et boire. Ce n'est pas une question d'avoir soif et de prendre de l'eau. C'est au moment où vous ne voulez pas boire que vous devriez vous forcer à boire. Et vous noterez qu'après avoir pris cette bouteille d'eau le matin, que vos urines sont de couleur claire et pure. Mais quand elle devient jaune, cela montre que vous avez besoin de plus d'eau. Il y a beaucoup de choses qui bloquent votre système, vos reins, votre foie, autres organes. Mais cela aussi réduira votre appétit à manger, cela aussi purifiera votre peau, combattra les maladies dans votre système et améliorera la croissance de vos cheveux. La thérapie par l'eau est très importante pour vous. Dieu nous a donné tout ce qu'il faut pour mener une bonne vie, mais nous sommes ignorants. Ceci est une question de discipline. La thérapie par l'eau est la clé pour capturer votre santé. Enseignez cela à vos enfants. Et alors que vous suivez cette instruction dans la justice, nous attendons votre témoignage. Bonjour à votre santé. Encore une fois, bonjour à votre santé.
The more you look at God, look to God, meditate on the word, the more you will find that faith comes spontaneously, naturally. When you realize that God is reliable, your faith will spontaneously grow. Faith is a trust. that arises out of the power that the other person is honest, trustworthy, reliable, and stable. Faith is perfected by our acting on God's will. By looking into the well and at it, you bring Jesus on the scene.